Riddle me this. What's the difference between a Ferrari and a state-of-the-art AI model? You can actually afford to look at the Ferrari. Meanwhile, these open-source models are sitting there like some cruel joke. Sure, you can download them, you can even name them, but actually running them? That's going to cost you more than a small house. We're talking $500,000 in hardware just to have a conversation with ChatGPT's smarter cousin. So what do the peasants like us do? We get the diet versions. The researchers take these massive models and shrink them down, like putting a bodybuilder on a starvation diet. Sometimes they cut the hardware requirements by 90%, which sounds amazing until you realize 90% cheaper still means you need a $30,000 graphics card. Cool, now I only need to sell one kidney instead of both. Your other option? Go even smaller, maybe a 7 billion parameter model. Or, if you're really struggling, a 1.5 billion one. But here's the thing. Talking to these tiny models is like having a philosophical debate with a goldfish. Sure, it'll respond, but you'll spend more time being frustrated than impressed. Enter the beautiful disaster that is quantization. Normally, these AI weights are stored as FP16. That's 16 bits per number. Think of each weight as a parameter. So a 7 billion parameter model is literally 7 billion numbers, each taking up 16 bits of space. That's roughly 14 gigabytes that needs to live in your GPU's memory for decent performance. Got an 8 gigabyte graphics card? Tough luck, buddy. Sure, you could do some fancy offloading where you constantly swap weights in and out of memory, but that's like trying to cook dinner by running to the grocery store for each ingredient. It'll work, but you'll hate every second of it. But what if we just used fewer bits? Instead of 16 bits per weight, what if we used 4? Or, and hear me out, what if we went completely insane and used just 1? The catch is precision. With FP16, you can represent tiny differences between numbers, like 3.141 versus 3.142. With FP8, you're looking at chunks of 0.125. With 4-bit, everything becomes an integer. It's like trying to paint the Mona Lisa, but with a paint roller. But here's where it gets spicy. After we butcher these weights, we can fine-tune the model on a custom dataset. In our case, pure unfiltered Shrek quotes mixed with the finest copypasta the internet has to offer. Because if we're going to sacrifice intelligence for speed, we might as well make it memorable. Most sane people stop at FP8. It's the sweet spot between still kinda smart and won't bankrupt you. The performance drop isn't that bad, and you save 75% on memory. But we're not sane people. We want it faster. We want it smaller. We want it running on hardware so old it remembers when the internet was dial-up. So first of all, I went out there and searched for some training data. And then I made a script to scrape me some legendary Twitch quotes, because that's where all of the world's wisdom comes from. And then another script to scrape some copypastas. And lastly, got to work. That's including the libraries and merging the two text files. I mean, training data. And now, we loaded the GPT-2 tokenizer and model from Hugging Face, setting the padding token to handle variable sequence lengths. We imported our custom dataset from merge.txt and created a tokenization function that converts text to numerical tokens with max length 128. We applied this tokenization across the entire dataset with parallel processing to prepare the data for training. I got a lot of trouble compiling llama.cpp, but nothing can beat perseverance and a 235 billion parameter LLM. And now for the first results. Once upon a time, light air dump? Beam, humanity? I think we made him too stupid. That's just random slop. I don't think manually zeroing half of its weights was the best of ideas. So let's try it again without the zeroing. This time he should explain quantum physics. To an extent, at least. Quantum physics is a new chapter in the book of theoretical physics. Yes, at least something with meaning. The chapter is nitromethane? Yeah, now he's hallucinating. As you can see, guys, the file size is only 63.66 megabytes with 78 tokens a second, And remember, it's CPU only. Now that's impressive. Does he know what's 1 plus 1? Yeah, he doesn't. 1 plus 1 equals... and make him generate just one token, which should be the result. Well, at least he's really efficient. The result? An AI so compressed it makes a zip file jealous, so fast it responds before you finish typing, and so wonderfully broken that every conversation feels like a fever dream. It's not the hero we deserved, but it's definitely the one we're getting. That's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. A subscribe would really mean the world to me. And that's it. Bye.